What's up, EHPlabs? Gokuflex here, and in today's video, we're gonna be talking about what's in my gym bag. Now, everything in my gym bag, I found for me personally, helps increase my workout performance and just workout gains in the gym. So enjoy the video. So first thing we have in my bag is a rumble roller. Now, there's a lot of different types of foam rollers. You got the Yamcha type rollers that are just feel that most gyms have. They're pretty much just like soft foam. But for me, I really like the extra firm rumble roller. You can roll it everywhere across your anterior delts, across your quads, your IT band, your lower back, and just roll out everything. I foam roll every day before I work out. You can even foam roll post-workout as well. Next thing I have in my bag is my supplements. So we got OxyShred and BCAAs. Yes, you can take this before you go to the gym, but for me personally, I like to sip it as I'm warming up and as I'm getting into my first exercise, I notice that it just hits me a lot better once my blood's pumping and everything. Next thing in my bag are wrist wraps. Now these are the Barbell Brigade collab with Slingshot. These aren't full powerlifter length wrist wraps. These are, I believe, about like 14 inches or so. I find for myself personally, anything like less than 14 is a little short, and anything longer where it gets like powerlifter length is just like too long. It looks like you're wearing like big ass cuffs around your wrist. And for me personally, I have just really small wrists. So I tend to get lots of wrist pain, especially when benching heavy or just even overhead pressing heavy. Next thing I got as well is a myofascial ball. For this, anything I find that's tight using this, if I still feel like it needs to loosen up a little bit more, I'll take the ball and roll it. So especially like across my anterior delts and whatnot, I really like this ball. This is a ball that actually EHPlabs sell. They sell a pack. This is their smallest one that I really enjoy. Next thing I have is the squat sponge. No, do not use this for squatting because it is not a bar tampon. I don't know if I should say that. Do not use this for squatting, I repeat, because it makes the bar really unstable on your shoulders. You're not gonna use this squatting 500 pounds. You'll never see someone use this squatting 500 pounds. When 500 pounds shifts like this on your neck, guess what happens? Instead, use these for your hip thrust. These will save your hips and hip thrusts. Yes, hip thrusts are a girly movement. Yes, they help build your glutes and hamstrings, but with anterior pelvic tilt being so prevalent these days, the hip thrust is one of the best movements that you can do for your legs, especially your glutes and hamstrings, and to improve your posture. So any of you guys with bad posture that aren't doing hip thrusts, give it a try, it'll change your life. It definitely helped me. Next is knee sleeves. Now these are Slingshot knee sleeves. They keep your joints nice and warm and lubricated while you're lifting. Depending how tight you get them, they can even help increase your lifts as well. Next is elbow sleeves. I suffer from elbow tendonitis. I read in a magazine back when I was really young that, you know, skull crushers were the key to huge triceps. And skull crushers used to always irritate my elbows. They used to always make them super inflamed. But, you know, back in the day, we used to think no pain, no gain. And, you know, years later, I ended up getting tricep tendonitis. And these I use whenever I bench, overhead press, that kind of thing. Any type of pressing movements. Again, same thing like the knee sleeves. Keep your elbows warm and lubricated. Next is the Brute belt. Now I use this belt for weighted pull-ups. You can even use this for weighted dips. For me, I can throw like 100 pounds on it and still wear it comfortably as well. My whole life, I sucked at pull-ups. And then I finally started, you know, just grinding it out. Instead of avoiding pull-ups and just doing lat pull-downs, I started getting better at pull-ups. And from there, I started doing weighted pull-ups, started with like 5 pounds, 10 pounds, 20 pounds. We worked our way up. And as I got stronger, I saw my back grow as well. And next thing is the mobility band. Now this I think I got from Elite FTS. This is their, small orange band. But yeah, anyways, I use this for my upper body warm up. Next I have a Slingshot hip circle. Now I like to put this around my knees to help engage my glutes because for me I have lower back pain, which is due to anterior pelvic tilt, which is due to having weak glutes, weak hamstrings. So it's something I'm always trying to work on. And that's pretty much it, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Subscribe to EHPlabs channel. All my information will be linked down below if you want to come and check out my channel at Gokuflex on all social medias. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Much love, strength and honor. Aloha.